Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Oke, tanpa melengahkan masa, kita mulakan kelas kita pada hari ini. Oke, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, so today we will continue our lesson in electrolytic cell factors that affect the electrolysis of aqueous solution. Okay, kalau masih ingat last week kita dah juga masuk electrolytic cell, tapi itu ialah untuk molten lead bromide, okay, lead to bromide. Itu untuk electrolyte yang dalam bentuk molten. Okay. Untuk hari ini kita akan lihat kalau electrolyte kita tu dalam bentuk aqueous solution. Okay, so electrolysis of aqueous solution, factors that affect the electrolysis of aqueous solution. Okay, ini kita imbas balik electrolysis of molten lead to bromide. Okay, in lead to bromide we have only two ions, okay, lead to ions and bromide ion. Okay, lead to ion ni Pb2 positive and bromide is Br negative. Okay, so this ion Pb2 plus when electricity is flow, current is flow, Pb2 plus will move to cathode, which is negative terminal, and bromide ion will move to anode, which is positive terminal. So this ion will undergo chemical changes, akan berlaku perubahan kimia. Okay, so positive ion ataupun cation will discharge. Okay, kalau positive ion, dia discharge by accept electrons. Okay, for example, Pb2 plus accept electrons to form Pb, okay, which is metal at cathode. And negative ion or anion will discharge. For example, bromide Br negative donate electrons to form bromine molecule, okay, at anode. Okay, so discharge di sini bermaksud ion itu akan menghilangkan, kehilangan charge positif atau negatifnya. So cara dia discharge sama ada accept electrons or donate electron, bergantung. Kalau cation positive ion, dia akan accept electron. Kalau negative ion or anion, donate electrons. Okay, so kita hari ini akan lihat kalau electrolyte kita is aqueous solution. For example, dalam diagram ini, sodium chloride NaCl solution. Okay, so kita boleh lihat dalam diagram di sebelah tu. Okay, we have four types of ion. Okay, hydrogen ion, chloride ion, hydroxide ion, and sodium. Okay, hydrogen ion, chloride ion, hydroxide ion, and sodium ion. Okay, two positively charged ion and two positively charged, two negatively charged ion. So cation ada dua, yaitu hydrogen ion and sodium ion. Anion juga ada dua, yaitu chloride and hydroxide. Okay, so kalau kita lihat molten lead to bromide tadi, okay, satu ion, okay, one ion will discharge at anode and another ion is discharged at cathode. Tapi kalau case sodium aqueous solution ini, we have two cation and two anion. Adakah kedua-dua cation and anion ini discharge serentak dekat anode dan cathode? Okay. Nah, jadi jawapannya masih sama. Only one cation will be discharged, accept electron to form product at cathode. And only one anion will be discharged ataupun donate electron to form a product at anode. Okay, maksudnya di sini ialah kalau okay, kita ada two cation, H plus dengan Na plus. So, satu sahaja yang akan undergo chemical changes, yang akan mengalami perubahan kimia. Satu sahaja yang akan discharge. So, begitu juga dengan chloride and hydroxide. Hanya satu sahaja yang akan discharge. Okay, jadi persoalan dia di sini, macam mana kita nak tahu which ion will be discharged at cathode and anode. Okay. Apa faktor dia? What are factors that affect the formation of product at the electrode for the electrolysis of aqueous solution? Okay, sebab dia ada more than two ataupun dia ada two types of cation and anion. Okay. So, dalam aqueous solution, okay, electrolysis of aqueous solution, we have three factors that affect the formation of product. Okay, number one, factor number one is E not value. Okay, kita dah pun mengaji tentang E not value ni beberapa kali sudah. Okay, and then the second factor is concentration of solution. And the third factor is type of electrode. So for today, kita akan fokus kepada factor number one, okay, E not value. Okay, so E not value, kita lihat kalau dia at anode, electrode anode, which ion will be discharged? Okay, kalau kita ada two anion, okay, anions with a more negative or less positive E not value in the standard electrode potential series will be easier to be discharged and oxidized. Oxidized, dia akan apa oxidation? Donate electron?
Donate.
Receive. Donate kan?
Donate
electron. Okay, at cathode, okay, cations with a more positive or less negative E not value in the standard electrode potential series will be easier to be discharged and reduced. So kalau reduce dia
reduction accept
gain electron ataupun accept electron. Okay, so kita akan fokus pada factor number one dulu. Okay, so kita tengok diagram. Okay, dalam diagram ni, the aqueous solution used is copper to sulfate. Okay, copper to sulfate solution, CuSO4. So kita kaji dulu, how many ions in copper to sulfate solution? Okay, first tengok salt itu sendiri, garam tu, okay, copper tu, so dia mesti ada ion copper 2 Cu2 plus, sulfate SO4 2 negative, okay, and then solution itu terdiri daripada water, water, so water tu akan membentuk hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion. Okay, water tu akan dissociate, dia bercerai menjadi hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion. So in copper to sulfate we have two cation, positively charged ion Cu2+ and H+, and two anion, sulfate and hydroxide. So, batu kita tengok dalam diagram ni, yang anion, negatively charged ion, will move to anode, anode, positive terminal. Okay, and then copper 2 and hydrogen ion will move to cathode, negative terminal. Okay, so kalau kita buat eksperimen ini, okay, this is our observation yang kita akan dapat. Okay, colorless gas bubbles are released at the anode. Okay, and brown solid is deposited at the cathode. So colorless gas bubbles itu dia ada gas test lah, ujian gas untuk kita mengesahkan apakah gas tersebut. Okay, so inference kita ialah oksigen gas lah, ada reason ya. Lepas ni kita tengok. Brown solid is deposited at the cathode. So brown solid itu is actually copper metal. Senang saja sebab metal ini kebanyakannya berwarna grey ya, grey solid. Kecuali yang berwarna selain daripada grey ialah copper lah. Dia berwarna brown. Yang selebihnya memang kebanyakannya color grey. Okay, so macam mana kita nak explain lah, kita nak tahu reaction yang berlaku dekat anode and cathode. Okay, yang berlaku which ion will be discharged. Okay, so sekarang kita fokus kepada E node value. Okay, kita cari dulu standard electrode potential for hydrogen ion. Okay, ini. And then copper 2 ion. And then hydroxide ion, yang ini. And sulfate. Okay, SO4. Okay, so kita tengok semula dekat anode. Okay, an ion with a more negative or less positive E node value. Okay, kita tengok an ion. An ion kita ialah apa dia? Hydroxide and sulfate. So kita bulatkan itu. Kita nak tengok, kita nak compare which an ion has a more negative or less positive E node. Cuba kita bandingkan E node value dia. Which one is more negative or less positive?
Hydroxide.
Okay, hydroxide lah. Awak tengok nilai dia. Positive 0.40 for hydroxide, for sulfate positive 2.01. Kita dapati hydroxide ini is less positive. Nilai E node nya lebih kecil lah, positifnya berbanding dengan sulfate. So hydroxide has less positive E node value compared to sulfate. So maksudnya di sini at the anode, okay, hydroxide ion will be easier to discharge. Okay, kita tengok. So an ion ada dua, hydroxide and sulfate. The E node value of hydroxide ion, OH negative, is less positive than sulfate ion. Hydroxide ion, OH negative, is more easier to be discharged and undergoes oxidation. Okay, kita tiru saja ayat dalam table ni tadi lah. Okay, will be easier to discharge and oxidize. Sama maksudlah, undergoes oxidation. So macam mana dia undergoes oxidation tu, kita kena explain sikit lah. OH negative ion donate electrons to form water and oxygen. Half equation at anode. Half equation ni awak ambil semula dekat standard electrode potential. Okay, cuma kita tulis dia dari belakang ke depan lah. Okay, kita punya substance is hydroxide. So kita kena tulis hydroxide dulu depan. OH tu awak tulis di depan dan terbalikkanlah. Okay, arrow. 2 water molecule plus O2 plus 4 electron. Itu half equation at anode. Nah, kalau kita diminta menulis half equation at anode. So, what observation? Okay, observation kita ialah bubbles of colorless gas. Release dekat sini. Kita akan nampak ada bubbles of colorless gas. Release. So gas tu akan terkumpul dalam test tube ni lah. Terkumpul dalam test tube. So produk itu ialah oxygen gas. Okay. Hydroxide ni dia ionize ada dua produk lah. Water and oxygen gas. Nah, yang kita dapat observe ialah oxygen gas sebab dia menghasilkan bubble. So itu produk yang kita observe lah. Okay, and then macam mana kita nak confirmkan itu adalah oxygen gas? We use glowing wooden splinter. Glowing wooden splinter will relight. Dia akan menyala semula. Okay, untuk cation pula. Okay, we have two cation. H positive and Cu2+. Okay. So kita tengoklah dekat cathode, cation with a more positive or less negative will be easier to discharge and reduce. So kita tengok which cation has more positive or less negative. Okay, kalau hydrogen kita tengok dia zero. Cu2+ dia positive 0.34. So maksudnya di sini
more positive.
Okay, copper ion is more positive anode value. So maksudnya copper ion will be
easier discharge.
Okay. So cation ada dua, H+ and Cu2+. So explanation kita, the anode value of copper to ion is more positive than hydrogen ion. Cu2+ ion is more easier to be discharged and undergoes reduction by macam mana cara dia mengalami reduction tu kita kena tulis juga. Receiving electrons to form copper metal. Cu2+, okay, half equationnya. Cu2+ plus 2 electron produce copper. So kita tengoklah dekat standard electrode potential. Kita punya substance, reactant kita is copper 2+. Produk kita Cu. So kita ambil saja half equation dalam standard electrode potential ini. Okay. Cuma kita ubah arrow dia lah jadi satu hala. So observation untuk copper, produk kita is brown solid. Copper metal is brown solid deposited at the electrode. Nanti bila ada masa kita buat eksperimen, awak akan tengoklah dekat apa elektrod ini dia akan ada lapisan layer yang berwarna brown. Okay, di sekeliling carbon electrode. So that one is copper metal lah.
So untuk produk copper boleh jadi copper atom ke?
Boleh.
So maksudnya copper metal dengan copper atom samalah sir.
Boleh, sebab copper metal dia terdiri daripada atom. Sama. Macam oksigen, awak nakkah oksigen molekul pun tak salah. Ada soalan?
Sedang.
Okay. So ini ini ada dalam buku teks juga lah, ada dalam modul juga. Sama saja penerangan dia, awak boleh buat yang ini boleh buat bacaan sendirilah, okey. Sama saja cara menerangkannya. Kita tengok dekat sini ya, bawah ni, anode. Nah, dia bandingkan half cell standard electrode potential, anode value untuk hydroxide and sulfate. Nah, so dia akan pilih less positive anode value. Okay, will be discharged. Untuk cathode, cation kita is hydrogen and copper 2+. So dekat cathode, dia mesti cation with more positive. Okay, which one is more positive? This one, plus 0.34. So copper ion is more positive, anode value will be discharged and reduced. Dekat sebelah ni ialah dia punya flowchart lah, macam mana step by step kita nak mengenal pasti apa reaction yang berlaku dalam electrolysis of aqueous solution. Okay, kita nak dapatkan idea. So step pertama kita mesti tahu ions that are present. Okay, apa ion-ion yang ada dalam aqueous solution tersebut. Okay, and then kita akan tentukan which ion move to anode and cathode. Okay, lepas ion-ion tu move to anode and cathode, kita kena determine which ion will discharge at anode and cathode. Macam mana kita nak determine? Kita tengoklah. Dalam case ini kita akan rujuk anode value. So reason dia hydroxide ion is discharged because anode value-nya is less positive than sulfate. Nah, untuk copper, Cu2+, anode value is more positive than hydrogen ion. And then we write the half equation at the anode and cathode. Untuk hydroxide ion, ini dia punya observation lah. Okay, kalau dia discharge. Kalau copper ion, observation dia nanti ialah copper metal lah, brown solid deposited. Yang hydroxide tadi, observation dia ialah oxygen gas lah, colorless gas bubbles are released. So name of product, oxygen gas dengan copper. Explain how the product form at the anode. Okay, explain how the product is formed at the anode. So bahagian ini, explanation ini, kita rujuk semula pada half equation. Awak terangkan half equation itu dalam bentuk perkataan lah. For hydroxide ion, okay, release 4 electron lah. Sebab ini ialah oxidation kan, dia akan release electron. Release 4 electron to form oxygen and water molecule. Okay, untuk dekat cathode, kita tengok half equation ya. Copper 2 ion, Cu2+, receive 2 electrons to form copper atom. Ini kalau soalan tanyalah, explain how the product is formed at the cathode and at the anode. And then type of reaction at anode. Anode mesti sentiasa oxidation. Cathode sentiasa reduction lah. Dalam chemical cell pun sama. Anode with where oxidation reaction occur. Cathode is where reduction reaction occur. So itu untuk the first factor lah, anode value. Ada soalan nak ditanya?
Guru.
Ya.
Pak Mate, cathode hanya jadi apa? Negatif terminal kah?
Oh, dalam electrolytic cell, cathode is negatif.
Oh, dua ayat terbalik lah.
Nah, terbalik.
Nah, okay.
Kita tengok bateri ya. Untuk bateri kita, yang panjang ni positif.
Positif.
Yang pendek ini keton lah. Keton kan pendek ah, negatif.
Oh, okey okey okey.
Tu senang nak ingatlah. Ada lain? Soalan lain? Okey, ada juga case ah, nanti awak akan jumpalah dalam beberapa jenis eksperimen atau soalan. Okey, di mana the cation ada satu saja. Contoh inilah. Anion ada dua. Okey, ini contoh untuk sulfuric acid lah. Sulfuric acid dia akan ionize to form hydrogen ion, sulfate ion dengan hydroxide ion. Okay, because acid dia dah dissolve in water kan. So water tu akan dissociate into H plus and OH negative. Okay, sulfuric itu akan menjadi sulfate. So dalam kalau case macam ini, apa pendapat awak dekat cathode ini? Of course lah, hydrogen yang akan discharge kan, sebab hanya dia seorang saja yang wujud cation yang ada. So kita tak perlulah nak explain sangat tentang E-note value dia. Boleh saja nak tulis the E-note value of hydrogen ion is, nak kata apa, less positive ke more positive, sebab dia kosong kan, kita tak bandingkan dia dengan siapa-siapa. So kita tak perlu explain pasal E-note value lah. Kita just tulis hydrogen ion is the only cation present and will be discharged at cathode. Okay, sebab memang perlu ada ion yang discharge dekat cathode. Okay, nah, saya rasa itu saja untuk penerangan tentang E-note value for factors that affect the electrolysis of aqueous solution. Okay, ada soalan-soalan lain nak tanya?
Dan
okey, kalau tak ada, kita jawab sedikit soalan dalam Google Form. Saya beri linknya dalam ruangan chat, message lah. Okay, boleh buka ruangan chat ataupun message dalam Google Meet ni. Awak boleh copy lah link tu untuk buka nanti. Ataupun klik terus. Okay, so itu saja daripada saya. Kalau ada apa-apa soalan tambahan, boleh tanya dalam grup ataupun PM saya personal lah. Boleh?
Boleh, saya.
Boleh.
Okey. Boleh, sir. Dah ambil link tadi?
Dah, sir. Dah.
Jawab, ha? Dah, sir. Itu saja. Sekian. Terima kasih semua.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.